Hiya. My name is Kermit, and Gordon has asked me to say a word or two in behalf of the letter W. Now, this is a letter W, by the way. It is a easy letter to make. It's made with all straight lines. And you need a W to make such words as wash and woman and weeping willow and, I'm sorry, there was some sort of mistake here. I thought I was supposed to talk about W, but they sent me an N here instead. Now, that's an N, see? Three lines. Zap, zap, zap. The W, as I said before, has four lines. Anyway, the N is not a bad letter. And you need an N for nice, and there's an N in nifty, and there's a couple of them in nincompoop, and, as I was saying, the letter V is an okay letter. I mean, it's on the list of okay letters. A V is for victory and for very confused. And now this is an I, tilted, or it could be the number one. But whatever it is not what it was a couple of minutes ago. And some people will eat anything. So I hope this has been an informative little talk on the letter W or V or easy boy there, take it easy now, or N or whatever. Cool it there, fellow. Hey, listen, I think I hear your mother calling you. I'll see you around. Hiya again there. I think we got everything all straightened away here, and now I am ready to tell you about the letter W. And this, as you recall, is a W. And it's an easy letter to make if you're good at straight lines. Now, the sound of W is in a number of useful and common words. Words like wiggle. And W is also the first letter in the word wobble. And you... It's also in weird. Anyhow, without the letter W, we could not spell walk. And we also... look at that. We could not spell walk. We could also not spell the word wander. And we could... we couldn't spell... Wait a minute! Listen. Oh, we couldn't spell watch it. Without the letter W, we couldn't spell wrestle. And we couldn't spell whack, 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 whack. Oof. We couldn't spell warning. Listen, I warn you. Oof. We couldn't spell war. Oof. And we couldn't spell winning or weakening. Oof. We couldn't spell woe is me. Oof. Wow. Hiya there. My name is Kermit. And today I'm going to talk about the difference between more and less. Now you will notice that I have two glasses of milk here, and that there is less milk in this glass than there is in that glass, which means there... Hey, listen. What are you going to do with that? Well, let's do it this way then. You will notice now that there is more milk in this glass than there is in that glass, which means that there is less milk in this glass over here than there is in this glass, because there is more in here and that there is in over here. And, hey, look, you. Hey, now listen, you. I've had enough of that. Now, I'm trying to talk about the difference between more and less, and you keep drinking the milk. Now, I'm going to explain it just one more time, and I want you to sit still and pay attention and don't interrupt me. Now, you got that straight? Now, not a peep out of you, Sonny, or I'm going to teach you a lesson that let's think of it this way. More and less. You will notice now that there are more monsters than frogs here, which means that there are less frogs than monsters, which means that you're going to see more and more of them and less of me. Hiya. Once again, I'm here to present a little talk about one of the letters of the alphabet. Now, today, the letter is B, and this is a B. Now, the B sort of looks like a fat man with his belt too tight, you know? And B is a very useful letter if you are fond of bread and butter, because both of these words begin with a B. And, here we go again. Okay, well, now this is an R. The R looks a lot like a B with the bottom eaten off of it, in case you didn't notice. And R is used for certain words like rotten and ruin. And the letter P is a nice letter. I mean, it looks something like an R with one of the legs eaten off. And wait a minute. Hey, you. How am I supposed to talk about the letters when you keep eating pieces off them off of them, huh? Well, okay, now P is the first letter in a lot of different words, but I can't think of any at the moment. And it... well, that's an F, then. It's an F. Now, the letter F starts a number of words which I can think of, like, well, now what? Okay, that's a 1, or an I, or a small L, or a line, or dessert, depending on your point of view. Okay, now you've done it. You see what you've done? You've eaten my letter, and you've ruined my talk, and you've made me look foolish in front of millions of people on television. And I hope you're satisfied, you great big hairy ugly... Hi-ho! This is me, Kermit the Frog, and today I'm going to talk to you about two pretty nice words, namely, tall and short. And I've arranged to have two of my friends come in and help me about this. First of all, this is Sam. And hello to you, Sam. And on the other hand, this is Harry. Come on in, Harry. And hi to you. Now, you can plainly see that old Sam here is very short, because I have to be way down here to talk to Sam. Mm-hmm. While Harry, on the other hand, is so tall, I have to go way up here to look him in the face. Right? So you can plainly see the difference. Sam is short, while Harry is tall. Right? Oh, wait a minute. I guess I got that wrong. Actually, Harry is the short one, while Sam is tall. No. I was right the first time, really. Because it is Sam is the short one, while Harry is the tall one. No. Harry is short, while Sam is tall. No, actually, the tall is the short one, while short is the tall one. Wait a minute. Now, there's one thing I'm sure of, and that's that one of you is supposed to be short. No. That's no good either, because one of you is supposed to be tall. No. Now, listen, you guys. One is short and one is tall, because otherwise, how can I explain about tall and short when you're going up and down like that? Just a second. There's going to be a short pause here while I do some tall talking. Now, come on, you guys. You're ruining the whole thing. I'm supposed to be talking about tall and short. You're going up and down like that. How can I explain about you're supposed to be tall and he's supposed to be short, or he's supposed to be short and he's supposed to be tall? Okay, friends. I'm going to try again. But this time, I'm going to tell you about two other words, namely, little and big. Now, I've got two other fellows to help me this time, a couple of guys who don't keep changing size, you know. So, first of all, there's Frank.
Hi there. I sure am happy I can be here to help Mr. Kermit.
Yeah, he's a cute little fellow, isn't he? Now, on the other hand, over here is a fellow named Harold.
It's my pleasure to be here, buddy.
Yeah, okay. Now, you can plainly see the difference that Frank here is very, very little.
Boy, I certainly am.
Right. And it's pretty clear that Harold here is very, very big.
You betcha.
Okay, that's unnecessary, Harold. So now today we have talked about those two words, little and big. And, some other time I'll tell you about another word, huge. Hiya, my name is Kermit, and today I'm here to talk to you about this new, super up-to-date, latest model rectangle. Now, this rectangle, as you can see, is a very special shape. Now, the rectangle has four sides. Let us count them. Four sides. The top, that's one side. The bottom here, that's two. This side over here, that's three sides. And way over here, that's four. Okay, see, four sides. Now, you will also notice that the rectangle has four corners, and each of these corners is the same. In other words, each of those corners goes zzz, zzz, just like that, you see? Now, remember, friends, the rectangle with four sides and four corners, all the same, and it's got two eyes and... Two eyes?
Eye.
Excuse me, fellow, but would you mind sort of bugging out of here? Because I'm trying to explain about the rectangle, and if you could just leave so I could do my explanation about the rectangle.
Sure, buddy.
All right, fine. Now, as I was about to say, the rectangle here has four sides, one of which is broken. And it's also got another broken... Listen, why don't you just leave and go find yourself a circle or a square or something like that, huh?
Okay, bye-bye.
What you see here used to be a rectangle.
And it still is. Hmm? It's a wreck, and it's a tangle.
Hiya, my name is Kermit, and today I'm going to tell you about the word same. Now, same is when a lot of things are just exactly like each other, see? Now, like these two things over here. Now, you can tell by looking at them that they're exactly the same. You see, they both have four sides, and they are the same size, they are the same shape, and they are, what are you doing over there? Hey, you! Hey, well, get away from that! No, I'm trying to explain about how these two things are the same, and you come along and take a bite out of one of them. Now look what you've done. Now they're just as different as can be. Now this one over here is just like it used to be, and that one over there has got a great big bite hanging out of it. Now they're not the same at all.
Wait.
What?
Wait a minute.
What? Oh, look at that. Now they are the same again. Yeah, where was I? Oh, yeah, okay. Now, as you can see, these two things here are exactly the same.
Because they're not.
Why?
No.
Why?
They're not the same at all.
Why?
Well, this one's delicious.
Delicious?
Yeah. And this one, yucky.
Hmm?
Yeah. Oh, delicious. Yeah.
Greetings. It's me again, Kermit the Frog. And over here I have my nifty jelly bean collection. Now today I'm going to try to show you guys what people mean when they say the word most. Okay, got that? Most, right? Now, as you can see, it's really quite simple. Like, well, for instance, this jar right here has some jelly beans in it. See? Look at the jelly beans and you can see that there are some jelly beans. Got that? Let's go to jar number two. Jar number two. You can see by looking in jar number two that there are more jelly beans in jar number two. Got that? There's some jelly beans here. There are more jelly beans in here. Let us now go to jar number three. Jar number three. Look at jar number three. Wowee! Look at all them jelly beans. You can tell that this jelly bean jar here has the most jelly beans of all in it. Look at that jar. Most of all. Now, let us review. We have some jelly beans here. We have more jelly beans here, and we have most jelly beans here. Got that? Once more. Everybody ready? We will. What?
Ooh.
What are you? Hey, listen.
Jelly beans.
Oh, yeah, you got that.
Dango.
Well, listen. This jelly bean jar is empty. But we can still do it here. We can still do it here. Yes, I think so. Because this jar here has some jelly beans in it still. And this jar here now has the most jelly beans in it. You see, there are some jelly beans here, but this jar here has the...
Ooh, more jelly beans! Bango.
Okay, let's see. Okay. We can still do it, by golly. We can still do it. We have two empty jelly bean jars here, but we can still do it because we can still use the word most. Because now this jar here has the most jelly beans in it. See? Two empty jars, but this jar here now has the most jelly beans.
Jelly beans!
Listen. Wait a minute.
What?
Stay right there.
Where?
You too. I'll be right back.
What?
Greetings. It is me once again, Kermit the Frog. Pay attention. Come on now. Now, once again, I'm going to try to explain the word most. Now, this time, I have here my marble collection. Got that? At ease. My marble collection. Okay. Now, over here in this jar here, we have some marbles.
Some.
Okay?
Yeah.
Some marbles.
Yeah.
Right? In the second jar, we have more marbles.
More marbles.
And in the last jar over here, in that last jar there,
most.
We have most.
Most.
That's right. Most. There you are. And there we have a most unhappy monster. Hiya there. My name is Kermit, and today I'm going to talk to you about hair. Hair, right? Now then, hair is a part of you. It's not a part of me, because I'm a frog, and frogs don't have hair. But you've got hair, right? Right. Well, now the question is, where do you have hair? And the answer is, where do you have hair? Where do you find hair? Come here. Oh, there it is. Sure. Now, see there? Right there. People always have hair right on the top of their head. See the hair? Right there on the top of their head. So if you're looking for hair, you know where to find it. Right? Right there on the top of their head. You know, if you're people, but not if you're a frog. Remember? Frogs don't have hair. Remember that? Okay. Now, hair comes in different colors and different lengths. You can brush it with a brush, or you can comb it with a comb. And this right here is the hair comb for combing hair. And, wait a minute. It seems like I was somewhat mistaken. Some people not only have hair on the top of their head, but some people have hair on the bottom of their head. Now, when you have hair all over your face like that, what's it called? Well, we all remember what it's called, right? When you have hair on your face like that, it's called a, I used to know what that was called. It's called a, what's it called?
A beard.
Yeah, it's called a beard.
No. A beard.
Oh, a beard. Yeah. Right. So, if you're looking for hair, you know where to find it, right? On top of your head. And if you have hair on your face like this, it's called a beard, right? So, if you're a big grown-up man or Santa Claus, then you have hair on your face and it's called a beard. And there are lots of things you can do with hair. You can go to a barbershop and have a haircut, or you can wash it to keep it clean, or you can comb it with a comb, or you can brush it with a brush, or you can...
It's like a melody.
Let's see. As I was saying, you have hair on your head, in which case... Or you have hair on your face, which is called a beard. Or you can have hair all over you.
Ta-da!
Right, I mean, lots of big, bushy, furry, fluffy hair all over every single inch of you. In which case, what are you?
Monster.
In which case, you're a monster.
Yeah.
In which, that dum, case, dum, dum, that's dum. All I'm going to tell you about hair right about... Now, because, that's not necessary. Remember, I'm a frog, remember?
Yeah.
And frogs don't have hair. And so I'll see you guys around, huh? Hiya. My name is Kermit, and today I'm here to talk to you about walls. Walls. Now, a wall is sort of hard to explain, but everybody knows what a wall is. See that right there? That's a wall. That's a wall. Right. Now that's a wall. Now before this wall was here, I could walk way back up here and I could keep on going. You see, I could walk way far back there, but I can't any longer because there's this wall here. But anyhow,
That's another wall. Well, before that wall was there, see, I could walk way off to this side, but I can't any longer because there's a wall there. But I can still walk off to, well, you see, anyhow, before these walls were here, I could walk off to this side, or I could walk off to this side. But anyway, there's no wall in front of me, so I can see you and I can talk to you. But if there were a wall in front of me, I couldn't talk to you if there were a wall in front of me. And so that's all I've got to say about walls.
Hiya. My name is Kermit, and today I'm here to talk to you about the letter F. Now, see this letter? This is the letter... No, it's not. Look at that. That's not an F. That's an E. I asked them for an F, and they sent me an E. Hey! Hey, you guys! Come here!
Yeah?
Look at this! Look at this!
What's the matter, frog?
Look, I asked for an F, and you have delivered to me an E.
Yeah, so what's the difference?
What's the difference?
What's the difference?
Just look at it! Now, the E has three lines. You see, the E's got the top line, and it's got the middle line, and it's got the bottom line down here, you see? The F doesn't have those three. The F has got the top line, it's got the middle line, but see this part down here? The F doesn't have that part. That part there shouldn't belong. That doesn't belong there at all. Now, I can see if how you can send me an F.
There you go, frog.
This is an F. Hello there. My name is Kermit the Frog, and today I'm here to talk to you about groovy things that you can hear with your ears.
Hey there, frog!
And you, I suppose, are planning to louse me up, huh?
Oh.
Listen, are you going to behave yourself?
Sure, frog.
Okay.
Okay.
Now.
Oh, go ahead.
Okay.
Okay.
Now, today we're going to talk about sounds.
What?
Sounds.
Oh.
Right. Okay, sounds.
Yeah.
Now, that's why I brought my radio along here.
Oh.
And now, first of all, I'm going to turn my radio on very softly. Hear that music?
Yeah.
Isn't that nice? That music is playing very softly, you know? You can hear it, but you wouldn't bother anyone in the next room, you know? On the other hand, you can play a radio very loudly. Now, what's this?
Yeah!
See, that's loud. Now, this radio is very loud, and it's not such a good idea to play a radio loud because you might bother someone, you know? And therefore, we turn the radio down, like that. Now, that's the difference between soft and loud. Soft is nice and quiet, like this, and,
Yeah! Go, frog!
Loud is when it hurts the ears, like that. So we turn it down. Now then, we can talk about the... Hey, you! You shouldn't play the radio that loud. You might wake somebody up.
I can't hear you.
I said you might wake somebody up.
What? He said you might wake somebody up.
But that ends my lecture for today. Hiya. This is Kermit Frog, here to talk to you about the letter K. And, just a minute. Hiya, this is Kermit again to talk to you now about the letter K. And this is the letter K. And it, wait a minute. You okay? Okay, now, I believe we're all squared away. And, as you recall, my name is Kermit, and we are here to talk about the letter K. All right. Okay. So, the letter K. Now...
Hey, frog!
Oh, no.
Oh-ho!
Don't you know that I got enough troubles with this letter K without you coming up here? And if you take a bite out of that letter K, I'm gonna scream. Now, why don't you just be a help once in a while instead of being such a monster?
Hmm? Okay.
Yeah, that's what I mean. You're always trying to make trouble, and you never... What did you say?
Okay. Me help frog.
You're gonna help me?
Help frog.
Gee. Well, all right. Now, here's what you do. I'm gonna mention things that begin with the letter K.
K?
See? Now,
K.
As I mention these things, if you would bring them up,
Okay. Oh, okay. See, there's a bunch of stuff down here. Look, look down there. Where? No, down below.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
Now you go down there and you get the stuff and bring it up as I mention it.
Okay.
Okay.
You mentioned.
Okay. Here we go. Now this is the letter K, as I said before, and it is the first letter in a number of important words, the most important of which is my name, Kermit. And there is the word Kermit, and that is my name, and...
No.
No, not yet. And that's the word Kermit, and you will notice that is a K right at the beginning of the word Kermit, okay? All right. Now then, there is another important word that begins with the letter K, and are you ready down there?
Ready.
Okay, and the word is kite.
Kite.
Kite, there's a kite.
Kite.
Notice how he holds the kite.
Kite fly.
Right, ooh. Very good, very good. Ooh. You did that very well back there.
Ooh.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Now you can split. Right, okay. Now then, yet another important word that begins with a K is the word king.
Ta-da!
Yes, king, right. And there he is with his crown, you see? Very good, very good. I thank you.
Thank you.
And you can go. All right. Now there is one more important word that does begin with a K, and I sort of hate to mention it, but I got myself into it, so I guess I have to. The most important word that begins with the letter K is the word kiss.
Aha!
And,
okay, frog.
I knew this was coming.
Come here.
And,
Yuck.
Okay, thank you. You can go.
Ah.
That was enough.
Ah.
So that...
Oh, another K word.
What's that?
Karate.
Karate?
Karate. Hi-ya!
Hiya. My name is Kermit the Frog, and today we're going to do some exercises. And we're going to do some exercises with a couple of friends of mine named Harry and George, and they're bears. And let's see, where's Harry? He was right there. Oh, there's Harry. Hey, Harry, how are you today? Where's George? Huh? Oh, there's George. Hi, George, how are you? Yeah, ready to do them? Okay, first exercise we're going to do is touch your toes, okay? Ready, Harry? Harry, reach down and touch your toes, okay? See, Harry's doing it. He's pretty good at it. No, Harry, we're going to have lunch later, okay? Yeah. Okay, now, George, are you doing this? George? Listen, George, these exercises are fun. Now, come on. Look at Harry do them. See how Harry does them. Harry's great at these exercises. Okay. Now, the first exercise we're going to do is we're all going to stretch, okay? Now, see how Harry stretches. Way to go, Harry. Wasn't that fun? Okay, everybody stretch one more time. There's old George. Okay, stretch. How did George get lunch? Okay, and the next thing we're going to do is stretch our neck, like our friend Hubert, the polar bear here. Okay, stretch around there, Hubert. Everybody stretch around. Twist around in circles. Right, that way, Harry. Turn around in circles. Very good. And what bad breath. Hey, listen, next thing we're going to do is push-ups. And Harry, how are you going to do some push-ups? Come on, Harry. Harry, well, listen, if you guys aren't going to do push-ups, I'm going to leave. Goodbye. Big?
Bigger?
Biggest. Hello there. This is Kermit the Frog once again, and today I'm here to talk to you about the word in.
Hey there, Frog.
Yes, hello yourself.
I come to help you.
Yeah, well, I figured you might.
Mm-hmm. Oh, good.
Okay, well, listen. Do you know what the word in means?
Oh, yes, in.
In.
Well, I think so.
Mm-hmm, good.
Maybe I do. Huh? I'm not sure.
Well, we will find out.
Oh.
We will find out if you know what the word in means.
Oh,
because,
okay.
See this big box over here?
Where?
No, over here.
Oh,
over here.
Oh, that box?
See that big box?
Oh, yeah, I sure do.
Okay, I want you to go over and get... in the box.
Oh, not me. Uh-uh.
Well, listen. Don't you want to help?
Well, yeah, but... Oh, yeah.
Okay, well, go over and get in the box.
Okay, I'll get in the box.
Okay, watch the hairy one as he goes over and gets in the box.
That's me. Here goes the hairy one.
In the box.
Here he goes, getting in the box. I'm in the box.
No, you're not.
That's not in the box. That's being next to the box.
You sure?
Now, next to the box is not the same thing as being in the box.
This isn't in the box?
No. Now, I want you to get in the box.
Oh, in the box.
Okay?
Okay. Here I go, in the box.
Here he goes. Watch old Fuzzy Face as he gets in the box.
Old Fuzzy Face is getting in the box right now.
No.
What?
Now, that's not being in the box.
Oh, this is not in the box?
No, now you're on the box.
Oh, could have fooled me.
Yeah, well, being on the box is not the same thing as being in the box.
Oh.
Now, go on and get in the box.
You sure I'm not in the box?
No, you're not in the box. You're on the box. Now, get in the box.
Here I go in the box.
Watch him now. Watch him now as he gets in the box.
Here I go, getting in the box.
Where are you? In the box. What are you doing?
I'm in the box.
No, you're not.
Nope.
Now you're under the box.
Oh, I'm under the box?
Yeah, now listen, being under the box is not the same thing as being in the box.
Oh.
And being next to the box is not the same thing as being in the box.
Nope.
And being on the box is not the same thing as being in the box. Now why won't you get in the box?
Because I'm in the box.
And I think I am in trouble. I'll see you later.
Hi, Fred.
Hello, this is Kermit the Frog, and I am here today to offer to you the first in a series of lectures about the different ways that people can feel. Now, today I'm going to talk to you about being happy. And right over here, this is a picture of a happy face. Now, you can tell that because the face is smiling, and you know that someone who looks this way feels very, very good. You feel happy when nice things happen to you. And as a matter of fact, I'm very happy right now, because I am here talking to you, and that is a very nice thing to do. Now let's talk about some of the things that might make you feel happy. But now that is not the kind of thing that makes you feel happy. Anyway, that's the kind of thing that makes you feel mad. I think I'd better talk about being mad. Now I get mad when people do things that I don't like. Like when a monster eats something he's not supposed to eat. Now you can tell I'm mad by the kind of things that I say to the monster, like this. You big, dumb, stupid, rotten monster! You make me so mad I don't believe it! You are without a doubt one of the nastiest monsters I've ever seen! And I'm so mad I'm gonna tell all my friends how rotten you are, and nobody's gonna ever play with you anymore, nobody's gonna even talk to you anymore. That's how mad I am!
Oh, Froggy!
And furthermore, I'm gonna tell your mother on you!
Oh, not my mommy!
Your mother! And your mother's not gonna let you come here anymore!
Oh, Froggy, please, Froggy, not my mommy.
I'm gonna tell your mommy.
Oh, I'd be so sad!
You're gonna be sad?
So sad if you tell my mommy! So sad!
You'd really be sad,
huh? Oh, so sad!
Wow.
Look at that. Oh, so sad.
Yes. Hey, you know what?
Now we can
talk about being sad.
So sad.
Hey, listen.
So sad.
Listen, if you want to see what sad is, look at the monster. Yes. See the monster? He's crying because he's so sad.
I am.
Yes, indeed. And he's sad because he feels bad.
I feel bad.
Right.
I'm sad.
Hey, listen, you. Listen, you, don't feel so bad.
What?
Don't feel so bad because I forgive you.
You do?
I certainly do. Because you just now helped me show everyone what sad is. Hey, now, hand me that thing down there.
Oh, this over here?
Yes, hand me that. Now, look at that. See, that's a sad face.
Yeah.
Now, I had this sad face drawn so I could tell everybody about feeling sad. But you see, now, they just now saw you, and you just saved me the trouble of showing them the sad face.
I helped you.
Yeah, so now I don't even need it, and now I am happy again.
You don't need sad face?
No, I don't need it.
You sure?
Sure, I'm sure, because you just now helped me. I think I'm going to have to talk about being mad again. Listen, you dumb, stupid, rotten monster, how dare you! Kermit again. Now, by now, you probably all know that this right here is the letter B. Now, the letter B. And today, I'm going to talk to you about the sound of the letter B. Okay, now, the sound that the letter B makes is B. B. All right? And it is made by doing this. First of all, you put the lips tightly together like this. See now? See how tightly my lips are together? All right? And then you fill the cheeks with air like this. See? And then you release the air suddenly through the lips like this. Buh. 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 Okay, you got that? That is the sound of the letter B. Of the letter B. Okay, now then, for those of you who missed that demonstration,
Frog!
Yes, hello.
Hi.
Okay, hey, listen, I'm talking about the letter B.
Oh.
So you just kind of quiet down back there.
Go ahead.
All right.
I'll listen.
Now, the sound of the letter B is produced by placing the lips firmly together, thusly. See that?
Yeah.
Okay. And then you fill the cheeks with air, thusly. See it?
Yeah, it's very good.
And then suddenly releasing the air through the lips, thusly. Buh. Buh.
Yeah.
Buh.
Got that, yeah.
Okay, did you understand that?
I understood that.
All right, well, let us see if you can make the sound of the letter B.
Okay, ready?
Ready, go ahead. Okay, world, stop what you're doing, because I am here again, old Kermit the Frog, to tell you all about another really great groovy word. Now, today's really fine, fantastic, fun type word is between. See right there? That right there is the word between. Okay? Okay, now maybe you're asking yourself just, why is it that between is one of those great, groovy, fine, fantastic, fun type words? Well, I'm here to show you why. Now, you will notice that on my table over here is a phonograph record of the Beatles. And on top of the phonograph record of the Beatles is a donut. And on top of the donut is a ping pong ball. You with me so far? Good. Okay. Now the ping pong ball is on the top. And the phonograph record of the Beatles is on the bottom. And the donut, here it comes now, the donut is between the two of them. You see there? It's in the middle. And when anything is in the middle like that, then it is between, okay? Now then, let me give you another example. You see, now I am under the table. And now the ping pong ball, the donut, and the phonograph record, and the top of the table are between me and one of the ugliest monsters I've ever seen.
Ping pong ball!
Now you will notice that there is just the donut and the phonograph record and the top of the table between me and that ugly monster.
Donut! Donut!
Now you see, it's just the record and the top of the table between me.
Record! Record! Beatles! Yeah!
And now I'm sorry to say that there's just this table between him and
me. Table! Table!
And now you will notice that there's absolutely nothing between me and this monster, but I sure wish there was.
Frog!
Okay, now that was the number 9. Now, just to make sure you understand how many 9 is, way over there, I've got a big pile of blocks, see? And what I'm going to do is I'll bring 9 of those blocks over here, and we'll count them. Okay? So that's what we're going to do.
Hey, Frog!
Oh, no.
How are you, Froggy?
Listen, I'm fine, I'm fine.
Good.
But are you here to help me, or are you going to be just a big pest, huh?
Oh, Froggy! Oh, I come to help you!
Yeah.
My little Froggy buddy.
Okay. Well, if you want to help me, I'll tell you what you can do.
Okay.
Now, see that big pile of blocks way over there?
No, I don't see that.
Way over this way.
Oh, yeah.
Way back there. See those blocks?
Mm.
Okay, I want you to go over there and bring me 9 of them. Got that? 9 blocks.
How's that?
I say bring me 9 blocks from that pile over there, okay?
That pile, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
9 blocks.
That's right.
9, you say?
Yeah.
9. Oh, boy, 9. 9 blocks, 9.
What's the matter with you?
Hmm?
Don't you know how to count 9 blocks?
Oh, me? Sure.
Mm-hmm.
Sort of. No.
No, you can't count 9 blocks?
No.
Well, how many blocks can you count?
Oh, how many can I count?
Yeah.
Oh, that's different. Huh. Oh, 1.
1. Well,
1.
Let's see. Okay, I tell you what to do.
What?
Go over there 1 time and bring me 1 block.
Oh, 1! Oh, okay. 1 I can do.
Okay, do it.
I go bring you 1 block.
Okay.
Nothing to it.
All right.
Simple.
Just go. See the hairy monster. Go over there 1 time and brings me 1 block.
I'll bring you a yellow one.
Okay.
1 block.
Very good.
Thank you.
Now go over there another time and bring me another block.
Oh, okay. 1 more block. Okay.
1 more block.
Let's see.
See the furry one as he brings 1 more block.
I'll get you an orange one.
Okay,
orange block. 1 block.
That's right. Okay, now just do it again.
Okay. That's 2 times I went over to get 1 block.
That's right. Do it again.
You want me to go get 1 block?
Right.
That'll be 3 times I go get 1 block.
Yeah, I know that. Go.
Go, I go.
Dum dum dum. Another trip to the block pile for the fuzzy monster.
Dum 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 dum. There. 1 block.
Okay, again.
Again, you want me to go get 1 block 4 times?
Yes, 4 trips to the block pile.
Okay. Num, num, num. I bring you an orange one. There. 1 block.
Okay, another.
Monster make 5 trips to the block pile?
Rightio.
5 trips to the block pile, rightio. One block.
Again.
6 times you want me to go get 1 block?
Yep.
A monster getting tired.
Go, go, go.
Go, go, go. I go, go, go.
Mm-hmm.
Here's a nice yellow one. 1 block.
Mm-hmm.
Don't say it. I know. 7 trips to the block pile.
Right on.
One block. 8 trips to the block pile, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right. 1 block. 9 trips to the block pile.
Good.
1 block more?
No.
Oh, good.
Now look here. Now see what you got? How many blocks are here?
Let's just take a look at them. They're all spread out here. So let's just see. Let me see. There's I don't know. 1.
Well,
See, you brought one block each time.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, how many times did you go to the block pile and bring me one block?
Let me see. 9 times.
Right. You went 9 times and brought one block each time.
Yeah.
So, what have you got?
Oh, well, sore back.
No.
Tired feet?
No. You've got 9 blocks. Watch, I'll count them.
Okay.
So here we got 1,
yeah.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. See?
Yeah. How about that? 9 blocks.
Right.
I go to the block pile 9 times.
Mm-hmm.
I bring back 1 block each time.
Right.
And I got 9 blocks.
Right.
Oh, boy.
Now put them back. Hi there. This is your old friend Kermit again. And today we're going to talk about the word full. The word today is full. Now, as you can see, this glass over here, this glass right here, is full. It is full of milk. He really did it. He did it, all right. Now the glass isn't full anymore. Now this glass is empty. And that's all very well, except that I don't want to talk about the word empty. I want to talk about the word full. And it's very important to know about the word full. Somebody has to tell you about the word full. And if I can't tell you about the word full, who can tell you about the word full, huh? Hi, Kermit the Frog here. And today I have a new and special game for you. It's called One of These Things Belongs with the Others. You know that game? You know, usually we sing it, but today we're going to just play it. Okay? I'll explain to you what happens. Over here, you will note there are 3 circles. Count them. 1, 2, 3. Got that? And over here, you will see that there are 3 squares and 1 circle. Count the squares. 1, 2, 3. Count the circle. 1. Okay? Now then, the object of the game is to think about which of these things over here belongs over here with these 3 things. Got that? Note these 3 things here, you see? And look at these over here and see if you can tell which of these things here belongs over here with these 3 things. All right? I'll give you a hint. These 3 things over here are round. Okay?
Ooh. Circles.
Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, boy.
What are you going to do? Abbott. We're trying to play a game here.
That's terrible.
Oh, but listen. You can't just...
Yuck. Yuck.
You can't just come here and take a...
Yuck. Oh, your circles are terrible. Yuck.
But we're trying to play a game, and you can't just come and take a bite out of all 3 of these circles over here. Let's see. No, let's play. Go back to the game anyhow. Now, this thing here doesn't have a bite taken out of it. And how can it belong with these things over here, which all have bites taken out of it? And this one here doesn't even have a bite taken out of it. Let's see. An idea. Hey, monster! Monster! Hey, monster! Monster! Listen, I couldn't help noticing how you happen to like taking bites out of these circles. And so I just thought, I got a nice circle here, and I was just wondering, how would you like to, taking a bite out of it?
Hmm? No thanks.
No thanks?
No thanks. Those circles of yours are yucky and terrible. They taste crummy. Yuck.
Yeah, but, well, I guess there's only one thing to do now. Here goes. Yeah. Hey. Hey. Oh, that tastes pretty good. Hey, monster.
What?
Hey, this is delicious.
That's good?
Yeah.
That circle's good?
It needs a little bit of salt, but it's great.
I got some salt down here.
Oh, boy.
Can I try it?
Sure, have a bite.
Okay.
That's really beautiful. Isn't that nice?
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, wow,
that circle's delicious.
Wow.
Oh, I'll try a square over here, okay?
Yeah, how's the square?
Oh, the square is great.
Is it?
Oh, no.
Hi there. Once again, it is me, the world's smartest frog, to talk to you about another groovy word. And today's groovy word is the word round, okay? The word today is round. Now, I'd like to show you what round is. Unfortunately, there's nothing round around here. Hey, you guys, send in something round, would you? Okay, now that is perfect, because now we have a ball. And a ball, as you can all plainly tell, is a nice round shape. See, it's all sort of nice and even and curved and sort of like a circle, you know? Now, because a ball is round, it can roll, and it can spin, and it can bounce.
And it can sing tiptoe through the tulips.
And it can sing tiptoe through the, Wait a minute. Who said that? Hold on here.
What's the matter? You'd rather hear old MacDonald had a farm?
No, I would not. Now, you, sir, are a rubber ball.
So?
Well, rubber balls can't talk.
Neither can frogs.
Well, I don't really know what to say to that.
Just continue the lesson, old froggy teacher of mine.
Okay.
Okay.
As I was saying now, a ball is round, so it can roll.
You betcha we can.
Oh, that's very good.
Yeah, thank you.
And not only can a ball roll, but it can also spin. Very good spinning, ball. Okay, not only can a ball spin and roll, but the ball can also bounce.
Yeah, and the ball can also sing tiptoe through the tulips, through the tulips.
Wait a minute, hold it, you.
What?
Well, listen, rubber balls aren't supposed to sing.
Oh, yeah? Tell that to my brother. He was a big recording star.
I don't believe it.
Yeah, he was until a truck ran over him and squashed him out of shape.
Oh?
Yeah, now he's a football for the Green Bay Packers.
How will you stop that? Now just cut that out.
Hey, I got a lot of relatives, you know? Yeah, my Uncle Louie gained a lot of weight and became a bowling ball. And I've got a flock of little cousins who are Christmas tree ornaments.
Listen, you. Come on now. I don't want to even hear about your relatives. Well, listen, stop that bouncing and come back here and sit down.
Oh, I like
or
that.
I'm going to flatten you against the wall.
Hi, Daddy.
Hi there, son.
Hey, Dad, I'd like you to meet a friend of mine. Now, where'd he go?
Who was he, boy?
A frog. I was just talking to him a minute ago.
Oh, don't be silly, son. Frogs can't talk.
Yeah, I guess he's right.
Hello there. Kermit the Frog here. And today I'm going to talk to you about horns, okay? Horns. And I brought along some film to show with pictures of animals with horns. Okay, guys. Now, here's a side view of horns, and here's some front view of the horns. And some horns sit up on top of the head like that, you see? And then there are other horns which are sort of short and stubby like that. And then some are tall and graceful like that. And some are tall and graceful and kind of curly-cue, you know? And there's a goat horn that sort of curves around. And here's a fuzzy horn. See that fuzzy horn? And there's a big wrinkled horn, too. And these are beautiful, smooth horns. And these are sort of lumpy on the end, you know? And then some horns are kind of uneven and broken off, you know? And now here's a mommy with horns. And here's a daddy who's got horns. And over here's a baby. See the baby there? Baby with horns. Isn't that cute? And then there's a rhinoceros horn. I'm getting out. Greetings, frog lovers. It is me, Kermit the Frog, again. And today I'm going to talk to you about clues. Okay? Clues.
And this is kind of fun because it's sort of like being a detective. Now, let me show you what I mean. Over here, you will see that there's a little boy. And we're going to figure out what this little boy has been doing.
Hi, Frog.
Hello, dear. And we're going to figure it out by looking at the clues. Okay. Now, the first clue, in the little boy's hand, there is a hoe. See?
A hoe.
And another clue that in front of him is a watering can.
Mm-hmm.
That's a clue. And in his hand, there is a bunch of carrots.
Mm.
See that? That's a clue.
Mm-hmm.
And if you look closely at his overalls, you'll see that there is a little spot of dirt there.
Yes.
On the overalls. Okay? Now, looking at all of these clues, I have already figured out what this little boy has been doing.
Oh?
Okay? He has planted a vegetable garden. Okay? And he's been working very hard pulling weeds and watering. And today he has just harvested a big bunch of lovely carrots. Am I right?
Mm-hmm, that's right. I am a little boy who planted a vegetable garden, and I've worked very hard pulling weeds and watering, and today I just harvested a big bunch of lovely carrots.
Oh, I bet you didn't know I was a genius, did you?
No.
Yes, sir. Figuring out clues is one of the things which us frogs do best. Let us take a look at another case. Here's another set of clues here. And let us figure out what this man has been doing.
Howdy, bub.
Howdy yourself. Now, first clue is in his hand there is a hammer.
Yeah, my hammer.
Right, that's a clue. And in front of him, you'll notice that there is a saw and some pieces of wood.
Yeah.
And there's an empty paint can. That's a clue.
Yeah.
And there's a brand new birdhouse.
Yeah.
Okay, now judging from all of these clues, can we tell what this man has been doing? Yes, we can, and I will tell you. This man has taken those pieces of wood, and he has sawed them up with the saw, you see, and then he's nailed them together with the hammer, he painted them, and he has built a brand new birdhouse, right?
Yeah. I sawed up the wood, nailed the pieces together, painted them, and made this birdhouse.
Oh, well, isn't that marvelous? Oh, the wonders of me! I tell you, figuring out clues is really great fun. Let's try one last time. Now, here, there is a monster. Now, the clues here are that in the monster's hand, there is an umbrella.
Right.
And in front of the monster, there is a suitcase.
Right.
Now, judging from these clues, I can tell you that it is raining outside. And because the monster has a suitcase, we can tell that he's going on a trip. Right?
Wrong.
Wrong?
Wrong. Uh-uh. See, it's not raining outside, first of all.
Well, why do you have an umbrella if it's not to protect you from the rain?
Well, I'll tell you. See, this umbrella is not for protection. It's for lunch.
Well, then what's in the suitcase, then?
Ketchup.
Ketchup?
Yeah, who needs an umbrella without ketchup? Yuck! I'll just dip in for a little ketchup there.
It's got a whole
slap
suitcase
it on the umbrella.
Full of ketchup.
Here we go.
I think that ends my discussion on clues.
Care for a bite?
No, thank you. I've eaten.
Handle's no good.
Greetings! Kermit the Frog here, and today I am here to talk to you about this letter right here. And,
hey, Froggy!
Oh, no.
How are you, Frog?
I'm fine.
Good.
Now listen, Grover.
Mm-hmm.
I want you to be quiet because I am talking about this letter right over here.
Oh, okay, I'll be quiet. Okay.
Okay.
I, Grover, will walk on tippy toes. Shh.
Okay.
Okay.
Now then.
Sorry.
Now then, please look at this letter right here. Okay?
Shoes. Sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Who can tell me what this letter is?
That's a G. That's a G. The letter G for Grover. First letter in my name, Grover.
Right.
Just down, like down there. See? Big G. Grover.
All right.
Okay. Sorry.
Now then. That is the capital letter G.
Mm.
Okay?
Yeah.
Now then, everybody, look over here at this letter here. Now, who knows? Who knows what this letter is? Well?
Well, what?
Aren't you going to break in and interrupt and yell what letter that is?
No.
Why not?
Because, Froggy.
Yeah?
Froggy, I do not know what that letter is. I do not know.
Okay, well, take it easy.
I do not know.
Take it easy.
Okay, right.
Okay, because I'm going to tell you something.
What?
Okay, this letter over here is the letter G, right?
Yeah. G for Grover.
Okay. Well, this little fella here is also a letter G.
It is?
Mm-hmm.
Do you mean this little fellow here is also the letter G?
Yep.
It does not look like the letter G.
Well, you see, it's a small G.
Oh.
You see, this one over here is a capital G.
This is a small
G. And this one here is a small G.
That is a capital G.
See, they're both the letter G.
Oh, G for Grover.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Okay, well, now you've
got
it.
Wait.
What?
That's not right. That's a little G.
That's
and
a little G.
Grover should start with a big G, a capital G. Now, that's it.
That's it.
Right.
That's the capital G.
I like the... Wait. No, I want the capital G. I want the capital G. No, that's it. That's the Grover that I know. See, the capital G starts Grover.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no. No. Come back, capital G. Oh, I love you, capital G. I love my G. I'm going to take my G home.
Now, wait a second.
Oh, G, I love my G.
You can't take the letter. I mean...
Bye, Froggy!
Well, anyhow, he was right. The capital G is for Grover, and the small G here is for, can be for goodbye. Hello there, Kermit the Frog here, and today I'm going to say a word or two about this letter here. You know what this letter here is? This is the capital letter R. Got that?
R.
Yeah.
R. Mm-hmm.
Wait a minute. Look what you did. You great big hairy monster. I was here to talk about the capital letter R, and you came in and you broke it all up. So now it's not a capital letter R at all. This right here is the capital letter P. I didn't want to talk about the capital letter P. I wanted to talk about the capital letter R. I'm going to tell your mommy on you.
Oh, Froggy.
Yeah.
Oh, Froggy, do not tell my mommy.
I certainly am.
Not my mommy, Froggy.
She's going to fix you good.
Oh, no. If I fix it, Froggy, will you tell my mommy?
Well, I don't know.
Okay, I go fix it then. You don't tell my mommy?
Well.
I go fix.
Look at that. It's a capital letter R again. How about that?